The South Carolina Department of Public Health confirmed an infection from brain-eating amoebas in the Midlands.
Ortolta was found on the week of July 7th, but state officials have not shared the person's condition. The disease is incurable and in most cases fatal.
Our Caitlin Ashbaugh is live at Clemson University after speaking with researchers and medical experts about what they know. Caitlin.
Sydney, Mark, it's considered deadly serious, but also often under-researched. Despite its severity, brain-eating amoebas are rare, and that means that they're less popular for researchers to study.
Here's a close-up sample in a petri dish.
So Naegleria is incredibly rare, so there are not that many people that work on it.
It thrives in warm, fresh water during the peak of South Carolina heat. July, August, or September.
It likes to feed on bacteria.
Almost every time, the diagnosis is fatal.
A headache, fever, then it'll progress to vomiting, seizures. But oftentimes, if a patient comes in with those symptoms, they're typically diagnosed with meningitis.
The risk of infections are low. Less than 10 are reported each year in the United States.
It does take a good amount of pressure. It does enter through the nasal passages and then follows the nasal, the nerve that lets us smell up into the brain.
Clemson's Jim Moore's lab is working to lessen the impacts of the disease. One finding they made extended the life of infected animals.
We need to work on the route of administration, so figuring out exactly how to deliver that drug to the patient.
Not a cure, but still hope for groundbreaking treatments.
We are working very hard in finding a better treatment because it's absolutely necessary.
Medical experts do say that the risk is very, very small here, but it's important to note that this cannot be transmitted through humans. Because of that, awareness is still key here. Make sure you know what to look out for and to tell a doctor if you know you might be experiencing these symptoms and you've been near a place where you might have had contact with one of these organisms. Reporting in Clemson, Caitlin Ashbaugh, WYFF News 4.